Hey everybody, happy Tuesday. So today is day two of our Modern Calligraphy Summit, and we're going to be starting out the day with some painting this morning, same as yesterday. Today is extra special for two reasons. Yesterday was the start of our summit. This morning is the second day of our summit, and it's my sister's birthday, her 30th. Happy birthday to my sister. All right, let me adjust this a little bit because we're a little bit crooked. Hopefully without dropping my phone on the floor. Got it? Okay, good. Okay, so if you caught the broadcast yesterday, we had a little bit of an interesting morning. Apparently I was showing some cleavage and attracted the wrong type of audience because of it. So today I have a nice high neck shirt. Granted, it's backless, but I don't think that'll garner the same response. So I started this painting yesterday. These are my inspiration trees. This was my practice piece. I have now done this piece 3 times and I just haven't been happy with it because I really liked my practice ones and then the real thing just wasn't as good. I wasn't liking it. So try number 3 if at first you don't succeed, right? Good morning. So I did my watercolor wash. This is going to serve as my background because I want a little bit of the sunset here to kind of show through the trees a little bit. I'm going to be playing with some atmospheric perspective, which is the light and dark, because as you see things further away, they get a little bit more hazy and a little bit more blue. I think I'll probably start on this side so you guys can see what I'm doing. So I'm going to mix up some of my paint, which I have not done this morning. I have some of my colors that I got a little bit wet yesterday, so I'll reignite those a bit. So I'm working in shades of blue and purple. I'm really just going to get this thing really pretty wet in the blue section here and add colors to it as I go. So I'm using an unusual brush today. I am going to be using, first I'm going to get my paper towel so I can wipe this thing off. I'm using an odd brush today. This is the brush I typically use to mix ink with. It's super stiff, it's really gross, it's really old. I have 2 of them. I have this one and I have this one that serve the same purpose. I mix stuff with them because they're stiff and I'm not afraid to destroy them. So this is actually what I'm gonna be using for my trees today. I think I'll use the bigger one. So I'm gonna start with a few paler trees, so if I don't particularly like them, I can just cover them up with something else. And then I'm going to turn the music up. You guys want to comment, wait till I turn around so I can actually see it. And when I turn around, I'll wait a sec to see if you have questions. Sound good? Sounds like a plan? And I am going for some intentional dripping. I was going to tape it down further, but then I won't get the drips all the way to the bottom. So, no more taping it down. Really hard to see, isn't it? Okay. I'll throw a few dark ones in here in a second. Kind of see my trees starting to materialize over here. The reason I'm doing them light, I don't like these yet. Good, is that better? Okay. just love these so much, and these just are not, they're not looking sick. But the more I mess with them, the worse it's gonna get. Okay, so in looking at these brush strokes and these brush strokes, I feel like this wasn't the brush I used. These are have a pretty long sections in their strokes, longer than this brush is. So I have no idea what I would have used. And this is why I keep failing. All right, we're gonna try a few with this guy. I like the hard brush. It's more like, these have some pretty hard, just like stippled strokes to them. My brush just wasn't big enough. All right, we're gonna try this one, see if this works. Cause it was more like this one, I kind of dabbed at it, which is why I like the look so much. I think this is a little better. That's a little bit better. All right, we're gonna get crazy. We're gonna throw a purple one in here. Okay, so I'm liking this brush better. This is a little bit more of the look I want to go for. Oops, I hit a little bit of red paint in there. Whoops! Yep, I got a little bit of, it looks like a rose. I kinda like it though. I know it is a happy accident. I kinda dig it. Alright, so we're gonna throw a few more purple ones in here. So that's gonna be like our, so this is our background. This is gonna be our medium ground, and then the foreground will be even darker. That tree is not straight, is it? That's okay. Trees don't always grow straight. Oh, have you guys met my dog yet? Oh, she's coming to visit. Hi, sweetheart. Come here, sweetie. Wanna say hi? I'll go over colors in just a second. You guys need to meet my dog. I'm gonna take this down real quick. Hi, sweetheart. Hi, poppers. How are you? Oh, you're all wet. Must be raining outside. This is Monday. She's just looking for food. See, she's gonna go over, she's gonna check my trash can. Yep, that's how she rolls, little fatty. Monday. Hey, hey. And then she's gonna ignore me. Hey, leave it. Good girl, come here. Go lay down. So that's my dog. Her name is Monday. She's a Newfoundland. And now she's going through all the bags on the floor looking for food. She's not hungry. She's just a Newfoundland. That's what they do. Sleep and eat. Monday. Hey, leave it. Go lie down. Go lie down. She's staring at me like she's thinking. She's thinking about lying down. Color-wise, or paints specifically, I think. I did a little bit about paints yesterday, if you guys caught that video. I use a hodgepodge of paints. I choose my paints based on... Oh, she just stole something. Monday, come here, sweetie. She's a thief. Yeah, she is a complete thief. She will take things and then run out of the room with them and you never will see them again. The color I'm using right now is actually kind of what was on my color palette. It's purplish. I know that's not very helpful, but I use this color palette every day. You guys saw this guy. So it's kind of the purple that was just in here already. I didn't clean it before I started, so I'm not really sure where the color came from. It's just kind of a mix of everything. I just got a text message about salsa dancing. All right, I'm gonna make these run. Maybe I won't. Okay, so I tried. You saw that, I tried. All right, so I'm gonna make them bigger as they get to the center point so that the middle point will be what's closest to us. Okay, I decided to do my tree trunk while standing in front of it so it wasn't crooked this time. Okay, so as these are wet, I'm going back in. I added a little bit more purple to my palette to make it a little bit more intense of a color. And I'm gonna add a little bit of purple in darker so that it kind of bleeds out. And I should have done it earlier so it bled a little bit better, but I forgot. So I'm just adding a little bit of that darker color in. Finally dripped. Excellent. They're finally going. Alright, these blues have really receded into the background a little bit, so I'm going to put one more layer in there with a little bit more pigment to it. So you can see them all a tiny bit better. And then my blue will hit my purple too, which I kind of like. Any questions? No? No? We're good? Okay, I'll keep going. I'll move the camera over in just a bit, guys. Let's turn the light off so we don't have so much shadow. How are our questions? Do we have any questions? Give you guys a second to type them. So if you're just joining in, I am doing some watercolor painting that I started yesterday. We started with a nice valley in the middle with some washes. We're gonna do a sunset. I'm messing with some atmosphere perspective. My example is up here, and I just switched sides, which is proving difficult since my paint is now behind me. My favorite YouTube channel. Okay, I have to admit something to you guys. When it comes to watching things on YouTube, I am such a complete sucker for the makeup channels. I love watching those girls. They're so good. Other than that, I don't really have anything that I watch religiously. Well, even those I don't really watch religiously. I'm not going to frame it. Someone asked if I'm going to frame this. This is actually a gift for, I don't think she'll catch this. This is a gift for my mom that I've been trying to get done for months. And, you know how it is. We just can't find the time. Or we say, oh, I don't have time for that. No, I absolutely do have time. I just need to make time. So in doing my morning stuff, this is a perfect time to get something done that I've been putting off that's not work related. I don't know if you guys noticed that I switched from my right hand to my left hand. Being ambidextrous is very helpful sometimes. Now granted, I'm not as good with my left hand, but practice makes slightly better sometimes. Oh, someone asked me yesterday what this was, if I paint on my hand. Oh no, that was when I decided to backhand the iron the other day. That's also what you get for trying to iron your shirt while you're wearing it. I did wear like the stretch over the ironing board and my hand slipped off and I definitely backhanded the iron. It really hurt too. I was very unhappy about it. I'm gonna have a nice big scar there. Hurt like a mother. Okay, so there's our background. Over here, we have kind of more of our fore and our medium in our background. So I'm gonna add some of that medium ground into here as well. My purple is really bleeding pretty hard into my blues, getting blurry with time themselves. Kind of as they dry, they're fading out a little bit more. Is that what you mean? Okay, that one doesn't stand out very much. I'm gonna have to go back through that and add in some more purple. And to set it apart a little bit further, I'm gonna go a little bit further down. I have one more layer down here. Shows a little better. The other thing I'm noting is I don't really want all my trees to end at the same level. It's like this purple one and the blue one next to it just kind of accidentally did that. So I'm gonna bring this down a little bit further. Like so. It is coming together. Wait till you guys see some of the darker pieces put in here. It brings the whole thing together. It'll be so much better. Okay, someone asked if they were lightening up with time. You can see from one side to the other, it's significantly lighter. This one was a little bit darker though, because it bled into the background a little too much. But you can definitely see how they lighten up as they dry. All right, switching back to my right hand. So I'm gonna add a few more of the darker purple ones in with the other ones I just did. Okay, so I'm gonna do a few of the darker blue ones right now. The entire thing, it's washed from about here up. It fades pretty hard. You really can't see it. As it dried, it really lightened up. So you get some of this sunset in here, but the sky part, you really only see towards the edges. So this is still not my darkest blue. Swing this a little bit. It's not gonna be my darkest blue. I'm gonna have one more color that's darker than this. I know I'm blocking you, give me a second. My tree was crooked. Okay, so when I put this tree in, I did not equidistant it between the two next to it. I actually put it almost right on top of the tree next to it, because when you're looking at a forest, things are not equidistant to one another, and I want it to be a little bit more realistic than like a pattern. Gotta make sure my trees are actually straight. Oh, color-wise, I actually know what color this is. This is an indigo. It's my favorite blue. Okay, so that's gonna be our darkest one there. You know what I'm noticing? There's way too much negative space up here. I'm gonna have to chop some of this off so it doesn't look funny. I should have done the sunset part further up the page. Oops. Okay, I cannot get these trees straight, you guys. Painting sideways is really way more difficult than I thought. That one is, again, crooked. Oh well. Alright, I'm gonna add some more of the medium blues over here. Make my line first since I can't get it straight. Anybody think of any questions? I'll turn around in just a second if you want to ask anything. Questions? No? So, I mean, this is not very exciting. Just to see how much we paint. So I ended up with a little bit of a gap right here between these two, and I kind of like it, so I'm gonna leave it there. Instead of putting a tree there. Oops, splatter all over the wall. I am actually, I'm really bummed with how far down it is. Proportionally, it should be about like that. But that also means I don't have a whole lot of room down here for anything. I was gonna do some real pretty bright coral flowers and let them drip down. We'll see. I think this is probably where I will leave it today. I'm gonna put one more in here. There we go. Okay, so that's where I will probably end it today. I'm gonna play around with some flowers a little bit because I don't really know which ones I wanna do. I do know I want them coral and I know I want them to drip, but size-wise, like, I don't know if I want leaves or anything on them. So I'm going to work on that a little bit more probably tomorrow, maybe this afternoon if I have a little bit of time, so you guys don't have to see me do trees for the third day in a row. It might get a little boring. However, let me turn this down real quick. However, I will be back at noon today, Eastern Standard Time, to work through some calligraphy work with our Modern Calligraphy Summit. Today is being taught by Fozzie from the Fozzie Book. If you guys don't follow her on Instagram, she is an amazing artist who I look up to so much. She and I just had a discussion this morning on classic versus contemporary calligraphy, and we'll talk a little bit more about that later. But that's at noon, so I'm gonna pre-watch her video and then we're gonna talk a little bit about developing your own style in calligraphy and hand lettering, how to actually go about doing that, and I'll work through some alphabet for you guys. So I will see you guys later. Have a good morning and happy Tuesday.